Hey everybody, Mike Linville here with Web Bytes, bite-sized web training in less than 2 minutes. Today's topic is domain names. Every website on the internet has a unique address. That address is called an IP address, and it looks something like 192.24.7.15. Now the thing with that is that's great for computers. They can find out exactly where you are. Not real great for humans, okay? So what happened was back in the mid 80s, a system was created called the domain name system. And what the domain name system is it's like a large reference library. What it does, when somebody goes to a browser and they type in a domain name, it goes to the domain name system and it finds the IP address for that domain name, and then it sends you on your way. So let me give you an example. If you go to your browser and you type in blackdogeducation.com, you're actually going to be redirected to 204.232.247.67. Now, domain names come with two or more parts. And when you read a domain name, what you do is you start from the right-hand side and you read until you get to the next to a period. So the first chunk, if we use www.blackdogeducation.com as an example, the first part that you're going to read is called the top level domain. And for our example, that's .com. The next part is what's called the second level domain. That one is Black Dog Education. And then the next section, www, is actually the subdomain or third level domain. And then if you want, you can go on and you can have a fourth level or a fifth level if you need to, okay? Now, domain names are actually registered through companies called registrars, and you never really buy them, you just lease them. So as long as you pay the money and you do the renewals, you can use that domain name for as long as you'd like. Currently, the largest domain name registrar is a company by the name of GoDaddy, and you can find them online at godaddy.com. This is Mike Linville with Web Bytes. We'll see you next time.